Hey everyone, it's Caroline and welcome to or welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my first video in my back to school college advice series. In today's video, I'm going to be focusing more on college classes, but stay tuned for more on dorm life, dining halls, just general advice. It'll be good. So diving into this topic right away, we're going to be talking about how to survive college classes. I sectioned off this video into a few different categories, and I'll leave the timestamps below so you guys can easily follow along and find what you're looking for. To start, we're going to be talking about scheduling your classes. Now, if you already have your schedule done, don't worry, I'm sure you can still change it if you need to. But my first piece of advice would be to schedule your classes when you know you will be awake. And going with that, I would highly, highly suggest that you avoid 8 a.m.s. even 9 a.m.s if you can, especially if you're really not a morning person. Even if you think you're a morning person, 8 a.m.s are still gonna be hard. I know I'm really not a morning person, and I think my earliest class was a 9 a.m. my freshman year, and even that was difficult. If you're able to manipulate your schedule in any way to make sure that you don't have super early classes in the morning, especially if you're not a morning person, I highly suggest you guys look into that. Now, once you start scheduling your classes, you're probably gonna want to look at what professor you're going to have for your courses. One website that has been a huge lifesaver for me so far in college is ratemyprofessor.com. That website easily allowed me to search up the different professors for a certain class I'd have, and usually most of them would have some sort of rating with like some written reviews, and it would give me a better idea of which professor may be a better fit for me in terms of teaching style or just their overall review, if they're a good fit for students or not. A few other places you could look for reviews on either professors or classes would be a Facebook group if you have one for your school, as well as Reddit. Those were two places that I'd look a few times as well, but Rate My Professor has been my number one choice usually. Another piece of advice that I have is to make sure that you have enough classes in your schedule. Now, I know credit hours kind of vary at different universities, but where I go to school, to be considered a full-time student, you have to have anywhere between 12 to 18 credit hours. So 12 is the minimum, 18 is the maximum until you have to override. With that range in mind, I would strongly advise to shoot for 15 if you can. And I will go into more detail as to why I choose that number later on in this video. So that's all I have for scheduling your classes. Now I have a few pieces of advice for when your classes start. First things first, read your syllabi. I remember throughout high school, we'd get syllabi every once in a while, but they're like, they weren't super helpful. They didn't usually have that much information, but they also always told us, you know, this is just practice for college, because in college, you really need to read through your syllabus and make sure you're getting everything down. So I highly suggest you guys go through your syllabi once you get them, especially your first week of classes, or even if you get them before classes start, that's a great time to look at them as well. So when you're looking through all of your syllabi, my next piece of advice would be to write down any assignment due dates and exam dates that you may have right away. So that way it's less likely for you to be scrambling throughout the semester, because it's possible that your professor may not remind you about any of your assignment dates, and they're just gonna expect you to know when your assignments are due because they gave you the syllabus. Really, really read through it and get it all down within that first week, because it'll keep you much more organized and much more relaxed throughout the semester. Next, I would suggest to find a few friends in each of your classes that you can communicate with, work with, study with all throughout your semester. I find that having at least one or two people in each class that you can talk to if you have any questions or you just need some clarification on things really quickly, it can be super helpful, because when you're working with others, that's basically another way of studying and relearning the information you've been learning, so it sticks in your brain more. There's tons of science backing all of that up, but the way I said it was just, you know, simple. Next, I would suggest to look at the lessons ahead of time if they are available to you. I remember in one of my courses, our professor would always put the lecture slides ahead of time on Sunday for the week, so people could easily just print them out or look them over a little bit. So that way, when you go to lecture and we're going through the slides, you already have a little bit of an idea of what you're going to be learning, and you could jot down extra notes next to the notes that you either already printed out or written down yourself, however it is that you like to take notes. That can be super helpful and honestly save you so much more time, because learning material in college, it can be very difficult because it's a lot in a short amount of time. My next piece of advice is going to go back to those 15 credit hours I mentioned that you should try to aim for when you schedule your classes, and it is to not be afraid to drop a class. Say you are at 12 credit hours and there's a class that you just really need to drop, it's just not working out for you, and you just need to get rid of it. Well, if you drop it, and let's say the class is worth 3 credit hours, you're down to 9 credit hours, and you're not going to be considered a full-time student anymore. And that may not be a bad thing for you, but if you have to maintain your full-time student status for any reason, then that may cause some problems. I mean, you can easily just add in another class, but then you're going to have to catch up on the work that you missed from that class, and it can be a lot. So that's why I always like to suggest staying in the middle at 15, between the 12 and 18. So if you have to drop one class, then you're down to 12, you're still considered a full-time student, and then again, it's less stress. Now we're gonna move on to some tips for when you're in the classroom. Number one, go to class. I know it can be tempting not to go to class, sleep in a little bit more, which is why I always say try to avoid those 8 and 9 a.m.s if possible. But yeah, just go to class. You're paying all that money to be taking these classes, so why would you skip the lecture? It's just a waste of money then. So just think of it that way, if that helps. Next, I would say to take plenty of notes. Now, everyone has different note-taking strategies, so you have to just find what works best for you. I did make a video talking more about how to study for finals, so there may be a few tips over there that kind of talk about taking notes. It's been a while since I've looked back at that one, but I'll link it up top so you can access it if you want. Next, I would say to keep your distractions away when you're in class. So obviously, I mean your phone and any other devices that you may have that would distract you during class, because if you're going to class just to sit on your phone, then again, you're wasting your time, you're wasting your money, you're not going to be retaining that information. So just keep it away, keep it turned off, and focus in on the lecture. Really just focus on why you're there, and it'll just help you out in the long run with your classes. All right, next we're going to be moving on to studying and homework. First, I would say to try and set aside some time to be getting your work done, getting your studying done, because that way when you have that set amount of time that you want to get stuff done in, you're more likely to actually do it, if that makes sense. Also, this is super important, but you need to remember that doing your homework doesn't usually count as studying. You have assignments, you have homework for a reason. Obviously, it's supposed to help you out, but it doesn't include those hours that you should be spending studying throughout the week. I know the recommendation at my school is that for every credit hour you take, you have to spend 3 hours studying that week. So let's say you're taking 15 credit hours worth of classes, then you should be ideally studying for 45 hours. That's basically like a full-time job. Do people actually follow that recommendation? I don't know. Maybe they do, maybe they don't. I'm pretty sure I didn't spend 45 hours studying a week. I feel like it really just depends on the class too. Just keep that in mind. Homework does not equal studying, especially in college. Next thing I would say is to find a good place for you to study. Everyone likes different study environments. Some people like it to be completely quiet. Some people like a little bit of chatter and background noise. With that, you're just gonna have to kind of explore the different places available to you. I know the dorm room isn't really the most ideal place to study, so I would suggest staying away from that area if you can. One of my favorite places to study was always the library. One of the libraries at my school that we have, there's one level where anyone is free to talk, so you kind of have that background noise if you want that. But then the level below it is where you have to be completely silent, so I always liked to kind of switch between those two, and depending on what work I was doing, I'd kind of choose which level I'd want to go to based off of that. Next, I already mentioned when you're in the classroom, but Same goes for when you're doing your assignments and studying. It is to keep your distractions away. Keeping your phone away and turned off is just gonna help you study that much more efficiently, and you're not gonna be wasting as much time. And like I mentioned earlier about finding a few friends in each of your classes to kind of do work with, here I am saying that you should definitely try to study with other people if that's something that you enjoy and you feel like you would benefit from. All right, so we're down to the last section, and it's just going to be some general pieces of advice throughout the semester for your college classes. The first one is something that you're probably going to hear a lot, is go to office hours. Everyone kind of uses that tip in different ways. Some people just go to office hours to introduce themselves to the professor. Some people actually go to office hours to ask really, really good questions about the material that they're learning. Some people go to office hours just to network with their professors and learn more about the field that they're interested in if their course is for their major. So there's definitely a lot of great benefits from going to office hours, especially if you are struggling in a course. So if you find that you're really not understanding some sort of concept in class, then go to office hours. Your professors are there to help you, to help you learn. So that's what they're there for. Next, I'd say to see your advisor. Now, you don't have to see your advisor every day, every week, throughout the semester. Usually the recommendation is to see your advisor at least one time each semester. So definitely find some time to meet with your advisor and just kind of talk about, you know, the classes you've been taking, how your semester is going, things like that. You should definitely check your emails regularly throughout the semester. You never know when your professor may be emailing you something important about an assignment, an exam, that class is canceled. Those are always fun. These next two things you can definitely do with your advisor, but I would suggest to keep track of the classes you've been taking. And also, if you want, try to come up with a four-year plan so you can easily see what classes you're going to take when, and then you don't have to stress about fitting everything into your schedule. Now, if you're undecided or you're not 100% sure on your major yet, don't do a four-year plan yet, unless you really want to sit down and make a bunch of different four-year plans for different majors. Go for it, but it's not a necessity, especially if you're undecided for now. And for my last piece of advice, and I think this is the most important one throughout your college career, and that is to reward yourself and take plenty of breaks. Now, it's very likely that you will be stressed with your college coursework at least once, if not more, throughout your college experience. So you have to be able to identify when you are on the brink of reaching burnout, because once you reach burnout, it's gonna be really, really difficult to kind of gain that motivation to keep working. Whether it's taking a 10-minute break in the middle of studying or taking your Sundays as a day to relax, whatever works for you is what you need to do, because again, you have to take care of yourself, because taking care of yourself is honestly just gonna help you do better in your courses. So with that last piece of advice, that is it for this video on how to survive your college classes. I hope you guys enjoyed and found something useful in this video to help you once your college classes start. Just to wrap this all up, as always, be sure to like this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you're interested in seeing more, and comment down below any other advice you have for college classes. Share your knowledge, share what has helped you, and it'll all help us in the long run. Again, stay tuned for more college advice videos from me as we are quickly approaching back to school season. I hope you all have a great rest of your week, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. We could be dancing in the stars, we could be floating on a lake, as long as I'm safely in your arms, and it don't really matter where we stand. Okay.